So I have been receiving a number of questions on how to get a Canvas test or quiz out of Canvas and into a Microsoft Word document. So today's lesson is about how to convert a Canvas quiz or test to a Microsoft Word document. And the overview of these instructions are right here. So just imagine you've created a test in Canvas. You're using question banks and/or some uniquely created Canvas questions. And now, for some reason, you need to print this out in Microsoft Word for any reason. Okay, it could be a student who needs to take this test in person. There could be a need for you to use this in a different class on campus. And you've got this great work and you're just trying to get it to Microsoft Word. Okay, so there's two steps we're going to follow. The first step is to export the Canvas quiz by following these instructions, and I'm going to demo this so you don't need to memorize this. And then step two is then you import it into Respondus. So if you are an instructor at Ventura College or within the Ventura County Community College District, you have both of these tools. Okay, so you have obviously Canvas, and you also have Respondus. So some people know how to use Respondus, some people don't. It's a very easy tool. It's free to download. Just go to the portal and search for it, and you can download it or talk to Matt or Sharon, and we'll show you how to download it. Okay, so these are two steps. Let's start first with Canvas. Okay, so you'll notice that I'm on my home page in my demo course. And the first thing I want to do is go to my settings. Okay, so I'm going to scroll down to where it says settings at the bottom of my course menu. And when I click on settings, it takes me to the settings portion of a course. And if you look on the right column, you have some options here. And one of the options that I want you to notice is export course content. So we're going to export the actual quiz, and then we're going to import it into Respondus. Okay? So you click on export course content, and you'll notice I've already exported stuff before, and it's going to export as a QTI file. So remember QTI. We're going to need to know that a little bit later. Okay? So export type right down here is the big step in Canvas. You're not exporting the entire course, you're just exporting a quiz. And then you'll notice you can select a specific quiz. Now, I would suggest you do this one quiz at a time. Okay, and the reason for that is Canvas codes these quizzes with obscure numbers, which you'll see later. And so you may have trouble distinguishing between the quizzes. So I'm going to choose just one of these quizzes, and I'm going to choose the one that's called James Garfield, okay, because it's a quiz that I use to show different types of questions, and you'll see that different types of questions actually get imported. Okay? Okay, so once I've done that, I choose Create Export, and it's going to process. And the most recent export is called New Export. Yes, I know it should have a better name than that in Canvas, but that's what we have for right now. So I'm going to click on New Export. And notice it wants to save it as a zip file. And so you want to save the file, and you want to put it somewhere you're going to remember. So I'm going to click OK. And it gives me a place to give it a name. So this is where I'm going to call it. Instead of Matt's Demos and Examples Quiz Export, I'm going to give it a more specific name, and I'm going to call it The Garfield Quiz, and you could call it whatever you want named on the title, but at least I'll know when I'm looking for it on my desktop, it's going to be called The Garfield Quiz. Okay, and it's a .zip file. Save that. Okay, and now it's on my desktop. So let's go and take a look at the desktop. Okay, so now I'm on my desktop and I'm looking for the zip file, and it's right here. It's called the Garfield Quiz. And because it's a zip file, I need to extract the contents. Okay, so in Word, you just, I mean, in a Windows environment, you just right-click on the file and you choose extract all, and it'll just put it right there on the desktop if you leave it with its proper settings, and it makes a nice little folder. So notice it made a secondary folder, just opened it, but I'm going to minimize that for a second. And notice right down here, it created a folder that I can use. That's the folder we need for Respondus. If you're using a Mac and you don't know how to extract a zip file or unzip a zip file, stop by and see Matt or Sharon and we'll walk you through the process. Okay, so you've done this first section. Okay, so you've done the first section. You've taken it out of Canvas and you've created the extracted zip file and now you've unzipped the zip file. Now we're going to go to Respondus. And once again, if you are not familiar with Respondus and you are an instructor at Ventura County Community College District, you can get this from the portal. Okay, so you can download it and use it from the portal. We have a site-wide license. Okay, so in Respondus, now what is Respondus, some of you are asking. So Respondus is a test creation tool. It also is a test conversion tool. So you can use it to move tests from system to system, and it will recognize the code in the question and help you go from test banks to digital world and from digital world test banks back to the Microsoft world, just to make it easy. And so there's lots of different personality types. So they call it concurrent personality. I know it's an interesting term. Not sure if it's a computer term or not. But as you click down on this drop down arrow, the important thing here for you to remember is that Canvas exports test questions in the IMS QTI type. It doesn't export it in the Canvas type. Okay, so just remember that IMS QTI. So it's very helpful because it helps you create things into other formats. So I'm going to choose IMS QTI. Then I'm going to import questions. Okay, so remember I unzip the file. And within that folder, there are test questions. And remember I said that Canvas puts a crazy number on these exports. Currently, that's why you only export one test at a time until you get really good at this, okay? Because sometimes it's hard to tell which questions you're importing. So I'm going to choose the Import Questions button, and this window pops up. And notice it says type of file, QTI. Okay, keep it at QTI. You wouldn't want to change it to anything else. Just leave it at QTI. And where it says file name, choose Browse. And this is where I'm going to look for that folder that I just created. So I'm going to the desktop and notice that, oh, there it is. It comes up at the top for me, luckily. It says the Garfield Quiz folder. Okay, now it says file folder, not the zip file. It should say file folder. I'm going to open that up. And then here's where the computer code ensues. All right, so it has this crazy number, right? Okay, that's why I only downloaded one quiz, because if I download 10 quizzes, I have 10 crazy numbers and I don't know which quiz is which. So I'm going to click on this particular one, and then there's two files here of XML. The assessment metadata contains no questions. Okay, it's just metadata. And if you're familiar with the term metadata and metacognition and stuff, it'll make sense to you. If not, don't worry about it. Just don't use it. But the quiz you want is this one, IFA 336, blah, 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 right? So it's going to be different every time you do this. And then you just choose open. So you're going to look down here and choose open. Okay. And everything is set up. Okay. You're not appending questions to the current document, but if you were adding extra questions, you could choose that option. We're actually creating a new document, so I'm going to call this Garfield Quiz. Okay, maybe I'll say Advanced, because I think I already have a Garfield Quiz in here. It might get mad at me, so I'm just going to say Advanced. It's the type, it's an exam, Okay, so just leave it set. Use stem plus, no, you're not doing anything like, well, you could, but I'm not going to do that right now. You can figure out how that works later. You click preview, and this is good news, right? So when you click preview, you start seeing the questions here. It says question type. Okay, it's got the questions, and you simply click finish. Okay, so it's creating the file. And you'll notice now, I'm going to change the window size a little bit here. So you'll notice now, if I were to look at the bottom down here, you see the questions, right? You can scroll, you can see that there's question types. And remember, I said I wanted to show you that it accepts lots of different question types, and you can kind of see what that looks like. Most of you probably use true and false and multiple choice questions. But, you know, it does accept other types of questions. Okay, so just be aware of that. Okay, and so now you're like, wow, I've got it into the system. How do I get it into a Word document, right? So the last step is, gosh, I'd like to have this in a Word document so I can edit it, add extra questions, yada, yada, yada. Okay, so if you go in Respondus to this fourth tab called Preview and Publish, okay, you'll notice that you have some options. Now, you can use Respondus to do a lot more than what we're doing right now. But for right now, we're just going to use the Preview and Publish button. And your print options is the third choice. So let's just imagine we've got this database of questions now in Respondus, and we want to print it out. Okay, you choose Print Options. You choose Exam. And there's, my goodness, there are a lot of settings here you could explore and add all sorts of functionality to this printout that you're going to create. If you want an exam with answer keys, you could do that. If you want the answer key only, you could do that. But remember, you're taking it from a dynamic, changeable database format to now a static format. So you will want to, you know, add to it the way you want to add to it. You can do headers if you want to, etc. I'm just keeping this very, very simple because really all we want to do is show you how to get to a printed format, right? Word document. So we're going to choose Save to File. And as you choose Save to File, notice it wants to automatically save it as a Word document. Not sure how this works on the Mac, but this is how it works on the PC. Give it a file name. So I'm going to say Garfield Quiz Advanced. Because I think there's already one in here. I tested this earlier. Okay, and I'm going to click Save. And it's creating a document. File is saved. Okay, so the file is saved. So now I'm just going to open it in Word. Okay, so trust me here. I'm going to pause for 1 second. And here you go. So this is the Word document. As you'll notice, I am in Microsoft Word. So there you see I'm in Microsoft Word. It's called Garfield Quiz Advanced. Make sure you remember where you save it. When I published it, I saved it to that obscure folder, so I had a little trouble finding it. So file management is going to be extremely important in this process. When you save something, make sure you know where you save it. Okay. This is the true and false question. Okay. See, it comes up nicely so a student could write on it and you can edit it, right? You could type in anything here. Right, so you can use your cursor. President Garfield's vice president was blank. Right, there's a space for someone to write in an answer. Charles J., and then you get to choose, and then there's your answer. So you can edit this document, right? So if there's too much spacing here, right, you can back it up. Okay, and you can change, and you can add questions. So you have a nice Word document. This question was an essay question, so I might want to give them a little bit more space to write. Okay, so I'll just, you know, type in there, give them more space to write. This question at the Centennial. Oh, so this was an odd question. So this was a drop-down window question. So in Canvas, they had to choose some choices. So this was a unique question where it was actually two choices. So you could decide how you want to do this question, if you want to reword it, etc., turn it into multiple choice. You also have a few more questions that printed out into the Word format. This is a fill in the blank. We've got an answer. This is a multiple choice question, and then this is a multiple choice question. Okay, so basically we were able to go from a Canvas file all the way to Microsoft Word. Let's just kind of review real quick what that looks like. So basically, remember, we started with exporting the Canvas quiz and test. There's a set of instructions that you follow to do that. You create the zip file as the final export, then you unpack the zip file. Then you go into Respondus and you want to import the questions. And remember, the format you're looking for is QTI. Okay. And then you make some suggestions and editing techniques and you import the questions. Then you go to preview and publish in Respondus, and you're basically saving it to a Microsoft Word file. So the reason we made a video is because it's really hard to explain all of these instructions and write them out. We do have this handy little guide that is an overview, but you probably still need the video. If you feel like you'd like this document, please contact me and I'll walk you through the process. But basically what you want to do is to test it out. You know, you don't want to be in a hurry to do this. You want to test it out. You want to give yourself some time to do this, because once you get through the first one or two, and you can partner up with one of us to go through it, the rest will be easy. So this is how to convert a Canvas test or quiz to a Microsoft Word document to print. Very valuable thing when you're working a lot in Canvas. Thank you for your time. Stop by anytime and we'll try to help you out with it.